Hey everyone, thanks so much for joining me for Chronicles and Collecting, where I'm going to open the Robot Spirits XXXG-01S Shenlong Gundam from New Mobile Report Gundam Wing. This figure came out in September 2013 and was a premium Bandai exclusive that retailed for 4,410 yen, or about $45 US.
Shockingly, it has not come up in any of the videos that I've done, but Gundam Notaku from Gundam Wing Endless Waltz, the Ultron Custom, is my all-time favorite Gundam and mobile suit in general. Unfortunately, there's not a Robot Spirits or Metal Robot Spirits of that figure. So the next best thing would be the Ultron, which I also don't have. But I guess the next best thing after that would be the Shenlong, which I do have. So I think this is kind of another one where the price has gone down a bit because of the Gundam Universe line. So the Shenlong just came out in Gundam Universe. And then, you know, probably not so surprisingly, some people were looking to kind of get rid of their Shenlongs. This figure is so nice. I absolutely adore this. The coloring is awesome. I mean, I've looked at a bunch of the Gundam Wing ones. This by far is better than all of them. I mean, it's not better than the Wing Zero Metal Robot Spirits, but it is super nice. I mean, just the detailing on it, the feel, the plastic is really nice. Lots of splashes of color. You kind of got the green over there. You kind of got all these nice painted details on the chest plate. You know, the back is kind of basic, but you got the gold accents on the kind of flamethrower hand. Obviously, the hand extends a little bit, and you got the shield. Could not be happier with this, and very, very happy that I, you know, bought it. You know, obviously, always thinking whether I should just take the easy way out and get the Gundam Universe figure. So let's take a look at the accessories here. So you have an extra Dragon Claw, and again, you got those really nice gold accents on it and the mouth. And pretty much all else you got there is the is, you know, this beam saber thing, and it's got two different effects. I think one is a little smaller, one's a little bigger. Just kind of take a look at the comparison there. And then you have some stand adapter parts. It looks like a few extra extenders for the arm and a bunch of hands. 2, 4, 6, 8. Yes, even number of hands. Absolutely amazing. So yeah, I'm really excited to take a look at this guy. I'll do some posing with him, and I'll be back with my final thoughts, though unless the posing goes really bad, I expect them to be overwhelmingly positive. Right, and we are back. So let's get this guy on the rotating stand while I kind of give some final thoughts here. You know, obviously I'm biased. This is one of my favorite mobile suits. Love Gundam Wing. Obviously wish I was looking at a Notaku, but Shenlong is, you know, the third best, as we've previously discussed. You know, every so often I think there's just a figure that reminds you why you collect figures, and this is it for me. Just love all the detailing, love the paint separation, love the posability. I love the arm mechanism. I love these little things you could put here to make the arms a little longer. I love the Dragon Claw. Pretty much everything about this is amazing. Cannot recommend this enough. You know, unfortunately, I don't have the Gundam Universe right here to compare it to. I hear that the Gundam Universe is very nice, but if you collect Robot Spirits, this is awesome. A few things that I want to draw attention to that I kind of missed during the unboxing portion. So I said there were kind of two Dragon Claws, which, you know, there are. But you can kind of see one is significantly bigger than the other. And also one of them has a fist while, you know, has the fist there. So, you know, if you wanted it to be holding the beam saber or something like that, you could. There is also a spot to hold the shield with the hand as well, which is good. And as I think I had kind of previously mentioned, there is a little adapter here for it to stand up. You know, I'm not going to harp on that. It's not a horrible adapter. It's fine. And there's also a spot on the back for you to hold the beam saber. Anyway, thanks so much for checking out this video. If you enjoyed it, I'd really appreciate a like or subscribe. And if you didn't, tell me about it in the comments. I do anime reviews on Mondays. This season, I'm doing a Meme Warrior at the Borderline. I do figure reviews on Wednesdays and Fridays. Thanks so much, and keep collecting.